little bit old for trick-or-treating, but that's
Hi!
Oh, come in!
Lewis,
please
Lewis.
Sit down, Lewis.
Thank you very much, Lewis from
Grindr.
I think that's where
people probably remember.
I said before, it's nice to be on the Savage Crew.
Well, welcome and happy.
This is Bibby.
Who is Bibby?
Oh, he's my little. You know what? He was abandoned by Green Buggers
like
a long time ago.
Is it a severed head in your pocket?
And, I mean, it's terrible that a circus, a company like that, who became so big, entertained so many people, they discarded a little guy like Bibby.
Bibby.
Say hello, Bibby.
And that's
Bibby,
just a head.
Bibby.
Bibby doesn't have a body?
No, Bibby's. He's head.
Oh, well, we're right near. That is where head is given. And what? Well, thank you. Yeah, I moisturize.
I hope I can get through this.
Well, yeah, the last time I was on a couch with a gentleman your age, Harvey Weinstein showed me his dick and offered me a movie role. So.
Oh dear.
Yes.
I promise not to say that.
Well, please don't. Well, it's all on camera, so.
We're being filmed.
We are being filmed.
Oh,
welcome to the cast.
Dirty son of a bitch.
It's 2017. Everything's on camera. What happened to your head, Lewis? Was it?
Oh, you have no idea. I had a fight with my boyfriend. And, you know, I mean, these things happen, and you run out of the house, you come back 2 a.m, I'm sorry, honey, I'm sorry, doll, and you make up and make love. He takes a fucking knife, and he just jabbed me in the fucking head!
He stabbed you. It looks like it fell out, though, so we don't have to call 911. And now it's back in.
It's back in now, Bibby. It's back in.
What were you and Lou? What were you and your? What's your boyfriend's name?
No.
What's this gentleman who did this horrible thing to you?
Oh, speak? Sandy.
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 Where'd you meet a man named Sandy?
On the beach.
Goes without saying, I guess. What was
a bit of a grind.
What was the fight over?
What do you think it was over? He said he was going out. He was staying late at work. The same old bullshit. And I was making dinner for him, and I'm gonna be home a little late, and this shit was going on, Lord. So I had one of these guys follow him, and he was in a bar with another guy, and oh my God, it was only business, I'm too uptight, you know, you gotta fucking calm down. One thing led to another, and he put the knife in my head.
Sounds like you should have put the knife in his head.
No, actually, I gave him head.
It's a nice way to make up.
It's, you know what? I'm not going to change the course of evolution. It is what it is. Dookie dookie, wake up.
Lewis, did you enjoy celebrating Halloween? Oh, well, that's fun.
I'm going to get jealous for you doing that. Bibby, stop. Bibby. Bibby, stop.
Is Bibby male or female?
You know, I don't really know.
Transsexual, yes.
Something like
there.
That. But Bibby has the tongue out. Kind of like the Rolling Stones.
Yeah, very, androgynous.
Let's spend the night together.
I think androgynous is the word
Hello.
The Stones used. Androgynous. Although Mick Jagger banged Hefner?
Who didn't? I banged Hefner.
Did you?
Oh, my God.
What was his dick like?
You know what? Years ago, he had a nice fleshy rod and everything. And it was strong and pounding and intense. It was throbbing. He had that thrust. And in the end, it was like a prune.
Well, they lose in the old age.
Everybody loses in the old age. It's a part of life. Don't get me fucking emotional.
It's
a part of fucking life.
It would not be Halloween if we didn't offer our guest a little bit of candy.
Yes.
Would you like to...
I love to dig in the bowl.
Would you like to dig into the bowl?
I love to dig in the bowl. I love to dig in the hole.
Well, yeah. I dig.
Razor blades?
Well, sometimes on Halloween you get stuck with some razor blades.
Don't you go trick-or-treating on. I won't. You're so beautiful.
Don't use those to open up your wrists just yet, Lewis. Have you ever heard of trunk-or-treat before?
No, I have to be honest, I never have.
Trunk or treat fucking blows. Let me tell you what trunk or treat is. And I'm sorry, I'm using you as a bit of a pawn to move my podcast along here. But trunk or treat is when Shitty, I see her licking, what's her name again?
Bibby, and it's not her.
What?
She's confused. He's confused.
Whatever it is a horribly receding hairline for an infant. How old is Bibby? Is that a shrunken head, or is that a...
Bibby's been around a long time, because Ringling Brothers, I don't think they can start the 1800s and everything. And there's like a lot of mythical things going on about the time of
Bibby's shut down
birth.
For vaping tigers.
And but you know what? When you have someone like Bibby, and Bibby's always been faithful to me, even after he fucking stabbed me with this knife, Bibby was here.
Bibby.
Head on head.
Is it possible that that your boyfriend, what was his name again?
Sandy.
Sandy. Is it possible that Sandy got jealous of Bibby and that's why he stabbed you in the head?
You know what? He's all washed up. He's on the beach.
Is he? Well, Sandy would be on the beach.
And all I need is my little Bibby. Move on, baby.
Her tongue looks a little bit dry.
I get moist.
Yeah, so parents are fucking up Halloween with this trunk or treat.
Okay.
I don't know if you've heard about
it. No, I haven't heard about it.
Allow me to fill you in.
Please fill me in.
Apparently, parents are afraid of people, presumably people like Sandy, who would do violent things on Halloween, like give out razor blades or stab someone in the head or maybe molest. I think they're really afraid of their kids getting molested is the big one. But, instead of going out trick-or-treating, they go to a fucking parking lot, and they set their cars up in a circle.
You have an orgasm by doing this on the couch. I'm sorry, go on.
not that way, usually I'm fucking the cushions. But anyway, yeah, they make you walk around
It was such a beautiful time.
Like
I'm sorry to interrupt you.
What's
Halloween was a beautiful time, and we always had to worry about candy and who's giving you what. And your parents always want you and watch that house. It smells moofa. You smell the mold, and the old man comes.
Were you going to get molested?
You smell the alcohol on his breath.
That's
his
exactly.
Breath, you know that right away he's been drinking. He lives alone, and you can tell right away.
And in comes Trunk or Treat. So that's why they created Trunk or Treat, is to prevent little boys like you from getting molested.
I love when you call me a little boy. Because I'm really nothing but.
Well, you have such rosy cheeks.
Oh, God almighty. You
boyish.
You have a way.
Boyish grin. Well,
do you have a girl in your life?
I do. I have several. I'm quite sorry. But anyway, I object to trunk or treat on the grounds that it is fucking impossible, near impossible to molest a kid on Halloween unless your kid's a complete fucking loser. Because they're all running around. You go out on Halloween in the suburbs, and there are a million dozens of people crawling the streets. They're coming up to your house in groups of three at a minimum, usually like five. How the hell are you going to squeeze in the time to molest? You would have to molest everyone in the group if you're going to molest one to engage in effective Halloween molestation.
I'm sorry, I lost you. I was doing the OJ.
Oh, the juice is on the loose now.
He's there.
He's
there. Sorry, I interrupted. I don't know. You know what? I mean, the parents have a point. They're a little crazy and all today. But you know what the thing is? Everybody should just carry around guns. Kids should have their own guns.
They should.
All children should have their own guns. And if something
happens,
you know
who doesn't get molested?
What?
A kid with a gun.
That's the whole thing.
Yeah.
And let me tell you something. NRI would be very, very happy about this. You make them money. You make the kids happy.
This is a perfect commercial for the NRA.
It's true. You make
and look,
them money.
He's got a
you
knife
keep them
his
happy.
Head.
I have a knife because
knives,
I'm Sandy
knives.
Cheating on me. That fucking bitch. Should die on that beach, and you know what? But the NRA, you keep them cool, you're making them money, you keep the kids safe, and the kid will just fucking kill who he wants to kill. He's have to worry because then
kids
you know,
are going to kill who they want.
You know, then they play a little game of hide and seek, and who won? Like, I won. So,
yeah,
you know.
Well, as long as they're playing hide and seek and not hide the salami.
You know, you do have to watch it today, you know, so I'm a firm believer in that.
In hiding the salami?
The salami.
So you were never diddled on Halloween. You were never molested as a child.
I was never.
Really?
Right, baby? He wasn't molested.
How unfortunate for you. Yeah, but I feel like if you go out on Halloween, you're trick-or-treating, there's like four of your friends. How the fuck is anyone going to molest? You would have to be an idiot to get molested. Like, you either have to be an idiot or a loser to get molested on Halloween. If you're trick-or-treating by yourself, I understand how you can get molested. But the only people who are trick-or-treating by themselves are fucking losers.
It's so nice and sunny out, right? Look at that bird. Just come on to that. Hello. Baby, say hello. Hi, birdie. Well, I don't know. You know, I have, like, mixed feelings about that. You know, because the kid doesn't know. The kid out there having fun and everything. And there are a lot of fucked up people in
and
the
he
world.
Just sees that fun-sized Twix hanging out.
That's it. He sees the fun-sized Twix. And all he wants is candy and be my mom. That's why a lot of parents, they walk their kids through the neighborhood today. The trunk-or-treat, you have to explain this.
Trunk-or-treat is bullshit. And as I was saying before you were distracted by the birds flying outside.
Please shake.
Dollar Shave Club.
Oh, my God. I thought that's Sandy used to love when I had sweet shave.
It's good. It's good to be well-emoliated. Is that it? Anyway. Trunk or treat is when these shithead parents set up a circle of cars.
I'm in the mood for love. Simply because you're near me. Funny, but when you're near me, I'm in the mood for love. You know I have the time. You could fuck me from behind. Funny, you're as sweet as a dove. I'm in the mood for love. Lately I've been feeling shitty. I love you to suck on my titty. Me and you, baby, we can rock. You know that you and I have a cock. I just made that up. Bibby likes that.
Big rat. Well, Bibby is very friendly. Shrunken head you have there. Well, the only people who, they're not getting fucked from behind in Trunk or Treat, thank God, but they are getting fucked in the ass because it completely ruins the Halloween experience to make your kid go fucking trick-or-treating in a fucking parking lot.
I agree with you.
And you know what? They don't even do it. They right. don't even do it on fucking Halloween anymore.
You got my vote.
They do it on, like this, we're doing our Halloween.
I think you're right.
Our Halloween spooktacular.
You're up there. You're
what's
right.
today? The fucking 20th? We're doing it. This is 11 days before
that's
Halloween.
The beginning of time, the calendar always changes.
That's bad because
Christmas
of the Jews,
is gonna
right?
Be in, oh, why do people always think they can't?
Well, the Jews and the Chinese have their own wacky calendars. Not my fault.
But I tell you what, they make
the Mayans too. They were all.
Let me tell you, the Jews make an awesome corned beef, and
I'm a
the
big
Chinese
egg. I'm a bagel guy.
Good egg rolls. But you have to go to the authentic
egg-roll.
Chinese restaurant.
You
they don't. They don't exist anymore. They don't exist anymore. And they made beautiful, loving bowl and poo-poo platters and come a young some guy. It was great.
You wanted to. You want to come on young some guy? Some young guy.
Kind of.
I prefer the hung young boy.
I miss Sandy. I miss Sandy.
I don't know how you could miss a man who put a
the
knife
of illusion
put a knife is. Through your head. But since you got razor blades on your first
Bibby,
your first
stop
dig,
spitting up.
Before you go, I would like to offer you this this pack of Skittles.
Thank you very much. And again, I want to say it's wonderful being on Savage Crew, and you look a little masculine, like you really like men, but
well, I am quite butch. I think butch is the term.
If you're
butch.
In the neighborhood,
it's butch. They refer to guys real masculine. I'm a stud, I think, in the like a well-oiled muscular guy.
Oh my God!
Not a twink. You're. I think you would fall into the twink category.
Oh, twink sounds so good. All I want
I know
is a nice warm mattress, a nice bubble bath, and someone who could just love me and be sensual. But even guys today, you know, it used to be like guys complaining about their girlfriends, complaining about them. But even, you know, that I'm I hate to say the word, different gay. But you don't find that affection anymore because they're the same cheap bastards, guys. I mean, It used to be we had our own thing going, and now they go with other guys.
And now with the Grindr app out there, they're just meeting up in rest stop bathrooms and pumping out a quick load, and that's it. There's no romance anymore.
Why do you have to get so bold? You can't be romantic.
Well, there is no romance anymore.
You have beautiful lips.
Grindr killed. Thank you.
All right, baby, say goodbye. Bye, Savage Crew. Goodbye. Very, very
goodbye.
Nice to
meet you. I'm happy that you have a very, that's a very ticklish handshake.
Oh, my God. It's rubbing the bottom of my balls.
Probably some preparation H might help.